All right, back to let's play Magnum Opus. So last I was playing, the Fire Nation attacked. All right, and so now we're on to chapter 3. There's a discarded paper. It should have some story in it. Let's look at it. Let's look at it. Pursuant to the Second Imperial Law Concerning Alchemy and duly promulgated amendments, the Imperial Alchemist Guilds hereby issue a license for the practice of alchemical engineering to the above personage in the service of the stated August House. That's Anateus of the House of Vantasin. Alright, so that's us. Story aftermath. Okay. I wish we had gone back. It was clear there was no choice for us. How I wish we could have, though. At least Frederick had survived. At least Frederick had survived. There would be some small hope. So it's if at least Frederick had survived, there would be some hope, small hope that Vantasin line could continue. Yeah, I'm just bad at reading, go figure. It's too late for that. We should be thinking about what to do next. There's nothing next. Don't you understand? Nobody will want to risk dealing with us. We'll have to live the rest of our miserable lives in hiding. I should have gone back and died with them. Concordia, aren't you mad too? Mad? I don't know. I'm not sure we deserve anything else after how poorly I defended the house. My career as an alchemist is in ruins. What a worthless pursuit this has turned out to be. Maybe it would be better to just forget it all. Listen, Anateus. Do what you want, but I know the only next step for me is revenge. I don't know yet how I'll achieve it, but that's the purpose of my life now. Is that another of the ways of the house's honor, treachery, swearing revenge? No, this is about me wanting to put a dagger through the heart of those Colvin wretches. How could they be so heartless? Concordia. I'm going to step outside. I know it's dangerous, but I need to take a very long walk. Wait, what? I'm just going to say that, whatever it is we decide to do, we'll definitely need supplies for transmutation engine first. I'll come with you. Okay, we're going to have some... We have two puzzles here, but, let's play the garden game first, because sure, why not? Alright. Let's see how far we can get. So far, just doing whatever is obvious. We're doing okay. Okay, I think I lost it. I think I've messed up. Alright, let's try that one more time. Alright, so those are first. Then, those... Those. I think this one. those together? No. Okay. There. There. I think that's the end of the game. Okay, third try is the charm. Third try will be my last try on this for now. Okay, so there. There. Alright, so this one with this one. This one with one of these. Which one's the best one? Let's go with this one, okay. So now, those, there. Those. All right, have I gotten myself stuck again? I think I have gotten myself stuck again, okay. Okay, I think I've officially got myself stuck again. Okay, so apparently I'm bad at that. All right, now let's do the actual puzzles. Before you ask, no, this gin is not because I am taking things poorly. It's for alchemy. I wasn't about to ask. It's a rather brilliant scheme, actually. I'm going to isolate individual elements from the alcohol. It's essentially the reverse of the process I used earlier when... don't ever give up alchemy. Okay, let's proceed to not give up alchemy. So the duplication glyph allows us to make... See, what are we doing? We're turning a thing into another thing, is what we're doing. So this is the reagent we're given. These are the products we want to make. I'll just put them up here for now while we're thinking. Okay, we will need a glyph of duplication. We'll need one of these, at least one of these, because we need to make... Okay, we'll also need one of these things that breaks the things. Okay, and the idea is that as this rotates, it'll allow us to turn things into other things. This somewhere like here. Basically, it's going to grab onto this, swing it over to here, and then that will cut one of the things, and then we're going to need one of these to grab the thing that gets cut, and then transport it. Since we need... Okay, let's start with green. So the idea is that we want each one of these to become... We want one of these to become green, one of them to become... Is there a better way to put this? I think this is probably the best way to put it, so let's just keep it like this. First thing that happens is two grabs, then it rotates that way. So and I'm just going to place all of these down for later. Alright, that's good. Let's see, and we'll also need it to pivot. Let's Okay, let's pivot it this way. Okay, that's good. And then we want 3 to grab. So at that point, that's when 3 grabs, and we'll rotate once that way. And then, okay, one more time. So let's do this. We did not grab it quite right. There. Okay, so that has become green. Cool. Okay, so now let's figure out. Okay, so when that happens, that will okay, so I think this should work. Okay, so that's how we make a green one. Right, then, 4. When 4 is ready, it will grab. Only need 3 to let go of it. Then 4 grabs. And then it will 1, 2, 3. So like that. Okay, cool. Actually, let's... Okay, I think, yeah, that should work, because then for the last one, instead of sending it up this way, we'll use this, and that might save some time. We'll see. So. Alright, so at that point, then we want 3 to. No, we want 4 to let go. Then we want 4 to return to where it came from. Alright, in the meantime, we want. So 2 to rotate twice. So where are we gonna put this? Okay, let's just put it here for now. So we want it to rotate twice. So that'll get us the next one. Okay, and so for the next one, actually, no, let's not do it that way. Okay, so instead of doing those, let's instead do it. No, that's why I didn't even do that. You can get it forward line. Okay, no way. We want to use those. Okay, so. Oh, didn't realize that was going on. So let's do that. Issue for 2. Wait, why isn't it going? Okay, so. Okay, so that's the issue. Okay, so is that now we're doing that. So let's throw that away. Put these like this. Now see what, how that changed. Do it like this now. There. Okay, So then 3. Okay, so 4, that's when it lets go and then returns. So in the meantime, we want arm 3 to be... Let's see, let's have 1. So then that rotates, then 3. That's when 3 goes back to. No, wrong ones. That's when 3 comes back to where it was, then grabs, and. Let's just do more of these. So after that, it goes back. All right. In the meantime, 4. I might need to spread these out a bit to make sure everything works, but it should be fine. Alright, so, what now? Okay, let's move those so those line up. Actually, so when 3 picks up 1, okay, what we need to line up is those. So let's move those like that. Okay, now, like that. 2, 3, then 1, 2, 3. Yeah, all right, let's see what that looks like. For the second one, since we're picking up the orange, we want to, instead of rotating 4 all those times, we only want to do it once. Something like that. Okay, let's see how that looks. Good. To convert one of these into that, so we want to rotate how many times? That's 3 times, I think, so. Let's figure it out. Something like that. Let's just see if that's the right number. Okay, that's good. And we want 2 to pivot. Want 2 to pivot twice. Not sure if it matters when. Let's just put them there. Okay. Yeah. We can move those earlier. Is better. Let's see what happens. Cool, okay, now 4 needs to rotate. Is that right? So. Okay, so there. Okay, so three drops it, then four needs to pick it up, and this time rotate only one, then drop it, then come back. Let's see if that works. All right, okay, that's good. Then to finish this off, we need two. Needs to, let's see, with the one it has, it's going to rotate to A and drop it. Then let's move these all of these back. It's gonna be something like this. Let's see how it goes. Nope. Up. Okay, let's see what didn't work there. Okay, that's the issue. Well, so that's part of the issue. So I got those reversed. All right, so. Let's see if that is better. A green, then orange. Okay, so that's wrong. We don't want it to rotate three times. We want it to rotate only two, I think. Hopefully this will work. Okay, now it works, that's cool. And let's just move these back to hopefully make it as efficient as possible. Machine that is not well oiled. It's okay. So low cost, middle of the road area, too many cycles. Yeah, that's how it goes. Let's see, this is definitely doing things the hard way, but oddly, it's kind of fun. Good thing there's plenty of cheap alcohol to be found around here. Unfortunately, alcohol only gets us part of the way. We need base metals too. Securing large quantities of metal, without raising question, that'll be far more difficult. We'll have to come up with some kind of plan. I have some ideas. Okay, so let's purify some water. Is that a glass of water from the river? How'd you guess? That lovely gray color was the giveaway. You weren't going to drink it, were you? We're going to need water if we're to remain here for the time being. I know you've never been to this part of the city before, but really, look at that. Right, we'll fix it. Okay, let's purify water. So that's the product we want. These are the reagents we're given. Okay, so here's what we're gonna have to do. We're gonna need a bunch of these. Let's go with two of them for now. We're going to need fusion. We're gonna need. Okay, in order to be as efficient as possible, what we're going to need is we're going to need to find a way to put one of these at the center of the thing. So for sake of argument, let's say it's from here, rotates down to there. Right, and then we'll need to also find a way to get a large quantity of calcified things. So this one, so that's going to put it there. That'll work, I guess. Or I'm trying to think of the best way to do this. If we bring the slowest way to do this, but it would work, would be to bring this elemental water in there. So bring the water here to the middle, then move these over, well, calcify them, and then put them in, rotate, and just do that over and over again. That would be the easiest way to do it, and it would work. But we could do this faster if we can find a way to if we do it like this, and then we're gonna end up there. Okay, so first thing that we need is two picks it up, then two is going to rotate down. Let's see if we put it there, will that work? Okay, so put it in, and then we're gonna have a series of pivots. It's I'm just gonna write them in now. It'll be a series of 6 pivots. Or actually just 5 pivots, so go be like that. Okay, after those pivots, it's going to be another rotation there, then it's a let go, and then reset. So it's gonna be like that. Then it resets. So that's the idea. And what I want to add to possibly speed up the process would be to... Is this the most efficient? I guess it would be more efficient to add another calcification one, but let's go with this. Okay, so... One is going to grab, and then it rotates that way twice, and let's go. I think like this. Okay, let's do it like this. See how it goes. Okay, that's good, the timing is right. Okay, and then for 3 is going to grab, then rotate, how many times does it need to go? dropping one of them. That's another one. Let's see if we can give three another one. So there, and then one, two, three, four, drop, and two more. Okay, so that'll give us one, two, three, one, two, and we need one more. All right, but so those line up, those line up. We want, see those line up. And then these are kind of out of phase. Let's move these like that. Okay, let's see how this goes. Okay, and we need one more to finish it off. Okay, and I guess they're both gonna take a while, so. One is faster. Neither of them are faster. They're both kind of slow. Okay, so let's see, is there a better way to do this? No, I don't think so. So those line up. Let's do it with the top version of it. Okay, so it's that, rotate twice, drop, bring it back. Okay, so make sure this works. Oh, too late. Okay, so this one needs to go like that. Make sure this works. There it is, okay. Gonna look at this one more time to make sure that it is moving as fast as we can. Yeah, I guess that's as fast as it can move. Alright, and let's just bring these all back so it's, whatever the fastest it can be. Alright. Yeah, looks like that works. Again, not like the most efficient, but it's pretty good space-wise, and I think it's close to as cheap as you can do it. So, let's go with that. But yeah, pretty low area. Pretty good on cycles, and pretty good on costs. Okay, that was a pretty good one. There, care for a sip. Why doesn't the great alchemist sample his own work? Cause I'm sure it's right. What a coincidence, I'm sure it's right too. You're no fun at all. Well, here I go. Well, it's fine. Water, slightly sour. Sour? Somewhat bitter, too. It will have to do for now. I'm going to get back to work. Okay. So now we have some story. So, Nils Whittle is the new guy's name. Anateus says, do we have a deal? It's an intriguing proposal. But the old Van Tassen compound is far more difficult to get into now that the Colvin occupies it. Their guards are far more vigilant. Believe me, we know. Concordia and I barely escaped with our lives. Just get me inside, I can take it from there. It's a little more complicated than that. The item we need isn't something you can carry on your person, it's a shipment. Specifically, a shipment of lead ore. I see. I'll supply you with a shipping order, but it needs a seal. You'll have to find a real order and take the seal from it. Okay, and then I suppose I'll impersonate a supply officer and take the shipment down to the river to you. Exactly. That's somewhat more fanciful than I expected. On the contrary, it's as feasible as they come. Practically a walk in the park for someone of your caliber, right? And don't forget, we'll supply you with the best equipment you'll find anywhere. If I'm to make you this gold, I'll need the lead. That's how alchemy works, after all. Ha 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 ha. Okay, gold, yes. I do like a bit of gold. Pull this off, and you'll have more than just a bit, I promise. Okay. So now we have a bunch of puzzles to work on. Okay, so let's do these puzzles. Let's start with the seal solvent. Affixing a seal to orders and invoices was always such a chore. The thought of undoing one is a little thrilling. Yes, what a bold and daring rebel you are now. The seals are complex, but the glue isn't. A weak point in this system. Surprising that hasn't been taken advantage of before. Maybe it has been. The Van Tussen stocks were never very closely tracked. Armand didn't care much for details, I'm sorry to say. If nobody misses it, is it really stealing? Spare me the please. Okay, so we need to build something that looks like that. We have those. Alright, so element quicksilver, element lead. We need to use. Alright, so we at least. I'm just gonna put one of these up here because I like those. We need at least one of these in order to. Here like this, we're gonna take lead, turn it into So first thing we need, so that's going to make one of those. Alright, and then we're going to have to fuse it to one of these. Not the most efficient way, but probably is easy enough to just do it like that. Will that work? I don't know. Let's okay, let's put this one. Okay, so this is the one that's going to let's reverse these around. So one is going to be up here. It's going to grab it, put it into position. This one's going to start here. Okay, so let's start with one and two grab. And then in this case, two rotates. So they both rotate in that direction. And then, was it arm two? Let's go. Like that. Alright, so that's good. That's what we want. Alright, cool. Then let's put first thing three does is three grabs, then three rotates into place. And then after the fusion happens, then one needs to rotate again and let go. Okay, so let's see that this works. Okay, that's good. We want. That's the issue. Let's put a bunch of these on so we don't lose track of things. There it is. Let's go. Okay. That's wrong. We want to, three picks up, shifts, it fuses, and then... all right. So that's fine. Then we need the calcification rune, which... It only can transmute the cardinal elements, so it will not transmute these. So we have to deal entirely with these guys. Okay. So then three is going to rotate. Let's just do two more times and then let go, just so we have an idea of what's going on. Nope, not quite. We need to wait until there. Oh, alright, let's do that. That should solve the problem. Okay, good. Oopsies. Alright, well, so if you hit escape twice, then it'll escape you. That's cool, that's good to know. Alright, so then we want three to come back to its starting position, which is... Let's come back the way we came, because sure, why not? Okay, so like that. Well, so... maybe it would make more sense to, let's not rotate that many times. Let's only go that many times. Okay, so. So then we're going to grab a new one. And then keep rotating. Okay, now we're going to have to start doing some fusions. So let's, for now, put in this like this should be fine, I think. Let's go with this, sure. Okay, so four is going to grab on when three lets go. Then four is going to rotates that way, then let go, come back, and grab, and it's that sort of thing. Okay, so three is going to have to come back and pick up again, so... like that. It up, do that, and then drop it off. I think we need to do that at least one more time. Okay, so so at that point, then three is going to move, drop it, grab it again. something like that. But probably we need to adjust these in some way. I don't know, let's just let it run like this and see what happens. I know what's going on there. Okay, so four definitely needs to be adjusted. Let's move that to there. See if this works better. There. Okay, that's good. That's all we needed, so another one of these. Okay, that's actually pretty close to what we want. Okay, so this is not going to be the most efficient way to do it, but it should work. Okay, so let's just double check to see what's going on. Okay, yeah, this is definitely not the most efficient way, but let's do it this way. Okay, so 6 is going to grab and rotate towards the A direction, and then let go. 5. Okay, we're gonna have to put this here. Right, 5 is going to rotate that into place like that. Yeah, this is definitely not gonna be efficient, even slightly. But so what 5 is gonna have to do, 5 is going to have to grab like that, and then pivot. And then let go. Okay, so let's see all this happen. Okay, we pivoted in the wrong direction. Let's see. Will it work? No, this might not work. Okay, it doesn't work because of the order of things. So let's. This happens after. Let's. There, boom. Okay, that's cool. Now. Okay, so once we do that, this will be sitting here, and we have to find a way to get it out. Okay, well, my instinct on how to get it out is going to be to. Let's put that there instead, and so that's moving that way. Let's just look at this one more time, maybe this will be better. Okay, what 5 is doing there, I think we might be able to rearrange it so that 3 does it and that 4 does it instead if we wanted to simplify this. Let's not worry about it for now. Okay, let's just put on another one. Yeah, this is not going to be a very efficient method. Okay, so at the end of all of this, 7 grabs on. So at the end of all of these, 7 grabs on. Let's just do this as far as possible. Then it retracts. Let's retract twice. And then it rotates in the D direction. And that will land it somewhere. We'll find where somewhere is when we get there. Let's let all of this go as far as it will go. There. And let's go. And we allow things to reset. Okay, so this will work, but it's not particularly efficient or cheap. But let's just get through this, and we can try to make something this more efficient. Like, I can try to make this more efficient later on in time. So that's the idea. I don't think there's too much specific dead time other than at the beginning of the cycle. It is... yeah. I mean, other than the fact that it's expensive, and other than the fact that it's expensive, I don't think it's that bad. Okay, as I said, it's expensive. The area was okay. The cycles is pretty bad also, so this is going to be one to try to improve on later. Yeah, it took a while to do also. Okay, seems a solvent like this would have applications well outside of the specific mission we discussed. You can keep it. Wait, are you sure? I'm not planning on a life of crime. I'm not planning a life of crime. Just the one crime. One or two. Once you start down the road, it's hard to go back. Not that I've tried. Okay, let's do one more of these. Okay, so climbing rope fiber. This is vexing. Were we still at House Van Tassen, I could supply you immediately with any length rope, and in a variety of width and colors too. I hardly need anything extravagant. I can make something better anyway. You don't need to create everything, Anateus. No, it's fine. I have an idea for how the fiber should work. It's possible the alchemist is rather enjoying himself. Okay, so... alright, so we need to build something that's going to go infinitely. We need units. Alright, this is going to be a bit of a challenge. So, what's going to be the best way to do this? Okay, so we're going to have to do something. Okay, so there are two issues. Okay. We need to calcify things, and we need to do the fusion. Okay, so I'm just gonna do the way that comes to mind for me. The way that comes to mind to me would be to basically, we're going to start by going to have this somewhere up here. We're going to have, let's say, something that will, let's see, put on a track like this. And this is how we are going to move things. We're going to start by grabbing it here, and then it will push that way. That's a safe space. We need to have it down here. Okay, so it's going to be something like this. It'll grab it and then pull it. That's how we're going to motivate them in this direction. I just raised my hand at the screen. It's not like you can see. Okay, but grab that. What we're going to need here is sometimes we're going to calcify things and sometimes we're not. So let's see the way to do it. These. So, okay, not the most efficient way, but let's do it like this. Okay, how do we do this? So, because here. All right. So, what we need to do now is we need to. I think the first thing to do would be to let's start replacing. Let's see, what's the order of operations? We need to place a. We need to place a normal one. Okay, so here's how I'm going to do it. It's not the most efficient, but it'll work. Okay, so we start by grabbing with two. So two is the one we're grabbing with. And then in order to calcify it, we... Okay, so in order to calcify it, we have to pull in like this. And then we rotate twice and let go. And then we want to get back to where we were, which is by doing that. And then we're ready to pick up a new one. Okay, so that's gonna look like that, cool. Alright, so let's just put those down now. Okay, so grab it, swing it up, that's cool. And then for this one, we grab it, then we rotate it around. Let's rotate the other way three times, then retract. Then let go, and then let's reverse everything. So that's going to be 1, 2, 3, and push it out. And we're going to grab another one. So it's going to be like that. So it's the other way. Cool. Like that. Alright, and let's do another one of these. I think this will be a fine way to do it. Okay, and then, so at some point, this is going to. Three is going to grab. Let's grab here, and then we're going to go in the plus direction. Then we're going to let go, and then bring it back to where it was by going in the minus direction. All right. So let's see if all this works. Okay. So just have to. Switch the order of those, like that. So there, that. Okay. Then in order to get that to work, two needs to, so after we grab another one, we need to, calcify it and then rotate it around. How many times is that? Three times. Go, and then let's just keep track of everything. Let's return it back to where it was. Like that. Alright, so something like that. Okay, so after that drops, we want to do that again. So that's see that this works. Okay, that's good. And then once that lands, then one can grab there. It can go plus. Which one is it? It's there. Okay, plus, then let go, then minus. Okay, let's see if this works. This feels like it should work. Okay, I think I see what might end up being an issue here. Okay, yeah, that's the issue. Okay. Yeah. That's not quite right. So, anyway, let's start by moving all of these. Here. Let's move this one here. Again, this is not going to be the most efficient, but hey, no one's perfect. Okay, so let's put this. It's gonna grab it and pull it this way. Okay, so four. Instead of three doing this, yeah, let's just run this and see what it looks like. Okay, that's good. That's what we wanted. Okay, so 3 doesn't do that again. Instead, 4 will. Instead, 4 grabs and goes plus drop minus. Let's see if that works. Okay, this looks like it should work. It's not the most efficient, but I think I'm fine with that. And it works. Cool. Yeah, this could probably be done more efficiently. It's sort of, it's a lot of parts, so it's going to be pretty expensive. And we could probably speed it up if we found a way to have 2 arms working on these green elements at the same time. But, yeah, it works. Cool. So, no, actually that's not too bad. Okay, so the area was fine. Cost is actually pretty okay. The cycles was the issue. Cool. Who knew that creating rope fiber could be so fascinating? It's not something I imagine they teach at alchemy school. Strong, resilient, yet light and easy to carry. I say a better rope has never been created. He's really quite absorbed. It's a shame most alchemists think work like this is beneath them. Imagine how different the world would be if we applied ourselves to problems like this one. All right, cool. Okay.